And it said, women are looking at the men differently now. They're asking, hey, can you fish? Can you hunt? Can you fight? Because it's that way now. And my son said to me when I was talking to him about it, he said, you know, the bad thing about it is these young boys with feminine, who have been feminized, don't even see that this was a plan. Because I told him when I was growing up, if this happened when I was 10, 12, 13 years old, I wouldn't be as worried, because every man in my neighborhood had a fucking rifle. Everyone. That's when this system was afraid of us, because they knew we weren't going to be the only ones to die if you came down our street in a tank. We have been weakened, people. We have been denatured. Because if we want fish, we got to go to them to get it. If we want clean water, we have to go to them to get it. And who can tell how clean that is? If we want anything, we have to go to them to get it. We have got to change. We have got to change. And I know that you guys get upset with me when I talk to you about this, but this is on us. This is our land. The Adolphs people don't want to accept that this is our land, but those of us who know that we are Aboriginal and that we are Indian, we better come together. It's not about how much money we can get for what we talk about. It's not about Cash App. Because Cash App ain't going to save us. We going to have to save us. I never thought that I would be the type of person to bear my feelings the way I'm doing it right now. I never thought I would. But what about our babies and our grandchildren? What about them? Because even if we survive this, they won't. 10 years from now, they got another plan. This ain't the only plan. I guess I'm really saying more than I plan to say, and I apologize for that. But we better take our lives into our own hands. We better start now. Even if it means just going to your neighbor next door. I told my son, I said, if this happened when I was young, I wouldn't be worried about it. Because if I got hungry, I didn't have to go to the store. I sat on my auntie's roof and ate cherries. And when we got tired of that, we ate berries. And when we got tired of that, we ate whatever they picked out of the yard. Or the bread that they made. We grew up on beans. We grew up on good food until they told us we were poor. We weren't poor. I didn't live in the ghetto. Our streets were clean. We believe everything they tell us about us. And then we turn to them to help, ask them to fix us so that we can be what they want us to be, so that we can look like what they want us to look like in their eyes. Let me tell you something. We better learn. We better get it. Another thing I said to my son, and then I'm going to get off. I'm not going to bore you with too much more of this, but I'm really concerned about the fact that we don't even know what real water tastes like. At least my children don't, and I bet yours don't either. Having foreigners on our land is a very serious issue. And let me tell you why. Some time ago, I went camping. And I was telling this white lady, I said, you know, I will never forget this time when there was water running down from the rocks. We went to that little stream, cupped our hands, and we drank the water. And she said to me, it didn't make you sick. No, it didn't. And it wasn't supposed to. You know why? Because my DNA is from this land. This landmass. So when I go to another country and I'm dealing with the DNA of that landmass, The water will make me sick. You got to understand that your DNA is in this land. You are copper, so is this land. People, just try and get it. Do some research. Go back into your family history and start finding out where you came from. Because if you are from Africa, then you need to be on that landmass. But if you're from here, you need to work to figure out how we can get our land back. How we can come together as a people. Because if we don't, we're done for. We are. And I know that other people don't say it out loud like this because they're scared. Well, let me tell you something. As brave as I usually am, I'm scared. I'm scared for us because we got to get it. We've got to see it. I don't care what religion you are. I don't care anything about that. It's about the bloodline. We're the same bloodline. We got to stop hating each other. We got to love each other enough to go to our next door neighbor and say, hey man, I'm your next door neighbor. We got to come together. We got to do like we used to do. We got to help each other mow our lawns. We got to start planting food in our yards. We need to get trees that bear fruit in our yard. So if you need something from me, I have it for you. Because I'm going to tell you, that's who we really are. And most of us don't even know, as Aboriginal people, we had the first World Trade Center. That's where they get it from. And it was a world trade, not a world buy. We bartered. We traded. Whatever we needed, we got from another country. And they did the same for us. And we've lost that. We've lost that care for each other and that taking care of each other. It's always about the money. What can you give me if I help you? We better get out of that because that is not who we are as a people. So, I've ranted. And forgive me for that.